So let's proceed. The first most often asked question in interview section is, tell us something about the position you're applying for. This is a very common question which comes often in interview section. It is a very cheap question which many people find it difficult to answer due to the lack of awareness about the position they are applying for. So in order for you to be able to answer this question perfectly, there are three tips that will guide you. So the tip number one is, before going for any interview, make sure you do some research about the firm and the position you're applying for. This is an essential thing which should be done before going for any interview. Firm varies among one another, so as their slogan varies, their mottos, their aims, their objectives, and their core values varies. Commercial banks in the city have different core values, aims, and objectives, so as their mottos and their slogan varies. And not just that alone, you should also research about the position you're applying for, because position also varies. A person applying for the post of a clerk will have to say a different thing from the person applying for the post of a manager. The number two tip is, before going for any interview, research about the requirements and the hyper pay standard for the position you are applying for. Qualifications and standard could either be human features like loyalty, honesty, accuracy, strength, commitment, or material features like the degree, your grade, the institution you graduated from, or your nationality. And the third tip is, after the research, put together valuable pieces and points gotten from the research and learn how to use them in answering the question. Tell me something about the position you are applying for. However, due to the diversity and plurality in jobs and positions, I won't be giving an example answer to the question, tell me something about the position you are applying for. But you can ask questions through the mail on your screen for any example answer for your respective position, and I promise to reply as soon as possible. Second question likely to be asked in your interview session is, what motivates you? Now, this is a very common question and also a simple question which comes up to in an interview section. I said earlier on, interview section is all about question and answer. The question and answer asked during the interview section are mostly orals. That means a lot of speech will be made between you and your interviewer. But it is pertinent to know that for every single thing you say during the interview section counts, and every single thing is say during the interview session will be used to qualify or to justify you. And that is why it is very, very important for you to be self-conscious of whatever you say during the interview. As a job seeker, I expect you to know that interview section should be professional, and for this reason, whatever you say during the interview section should always be professional and should only be pertaining to the position or to the job you're applying for. Never you say something outside, and if you have to say something outside the position or the job you're applying for, always try as much as possible to link it to the job or to the position you're applying for. And here is a perfect example answer to the question, what motivates you? Being determined to succeed and to make excellence in whatever I do has always been my primary goal, which I make sure I work towards every day to establish and maintain. This alone is a grand motivator to me, because anytime I remember my need to succeed, it boosts me and jam me up to do the needful, and not just the needful, but the max of what I can do to succeed. It also, naturally, I am a lover of success, and I believe to succeed is every human's characteristic, and it can be achieved by anyone who works for it. So whenever I see people excelling, whenever I see people succeeding, I found the courage and the strength to do things, and also the hope that I can also succeed. I get motivated by seeing or listening to successful people. Nothing but success only motivates me. Saying this is going to make you one step ahead of every other participant in the interview, because this is just the savage and a mind-blowing answer to the question, what motivates you? The third most often asked question in the interview section is, tell me about a challenge or conflict you faced and how you handled it. Here is an example answer to the question, tell me about a challenge or conflict you faced at work and how you handled it. Challenges are part of the values and bridges of life which one has to pass through in order to be successful. At work, I have encountered quite a number of challenges which I was able to resolve. I could still remember vividly one of the dominant challenges which I resolved. It was then back in 2018 when I worked as an hiring manager for KFC PLC. I got a task to interview two men who were applying for the post of a manager. During the course of the interview, I discovered one of them is a fresh graduate with little experience about how to manage a firm, although he graduated from a prestigious university with a good CGPA. While the other person is in his early 50s and has been a manager for a firm for about 18 straight years with a renounceable achievement within its year of service. This was a tough task for me as I held up assigning same point to both bosses, and I was unable to choose one over the other. As an hiring manager, my duty is to employ based on fairness. So in order to perform my duty perfectly and effectively, I have to set up a panel, which we all agreed on salary criteria to choose the requirements and qualifications and the best. Another section of the interview was both for both men and the panel serving as the judge. From that, I was able to choose the best candidates and the most worthy for the job. By doing this, I was able to avoid the problem of impartiality and biasness, because if I didn't set up the panel on the second interview, I may have employed the wrong person, which will later serve as a challenge to me. The fourth most often asked question in the interview section is, what is your greatest professional achievement? This is a tricky question which many professionals, many entrepreneurs find it difficult to answer. And for this reason, I have brought you an essential tip which will be used to answer this question correctly. And the tip is, as a job seeker who is determined to get a dream job, try as much as possible to stay several achievements, but always end it with, my greatest achievement is yet to be attained, which I hope it will be attained in this term if I eventually get deployed. Here is an example answer to the question, what is your greatest professional achievement? I started my career as a clerk, then I was working as a civil servant. Some years later, I made partnership with XYZ firm in carrying out the project. I also worked in partnership with UN Wildlife Adventurism in the year 2000, and we were able to convince and also impact knowledge in people about the HSR and the need for the preservation of wildlife. In my previous work, I won an award for loyalty and punctuality in the year 2000, and as every single day passed by, I keep improving in standard and everything. However, this time I passed by achievement, because my greatest achievement is yet to be attained, which I hope will be in this reputable firm of yours. Now, this is a professional experience, not just a professional experience, but a brilliant one. By saying this, you're passing a message to your interviewer that you're willing and ready to work because of you want to do something positive, because of your aiming at a greater height, and this is the best reason why a laborer will be him. The fifth question which you're most likely to be asking in an interview question is, tell me about the time you experience your leadership quality. Well, this is the beautiful question which your ability to answer it perfectly can give you an upper chance of getting the job. Many young ones first graduate found difficulty in answering this question, because men tend to say, I haven't heard any organization talk less about portraying a leadership quality, but here is an example answer to you.
Well, I just finished college, so I haven't heard any organization. But I could still remember vividly when I was in college, I headed a team in Canada a research project. We only had 2 weeks to finish it up and submit. The minute I got the research topic, I dotted out the introduction and a brief summary, and also the goal of the research project to my team members, and I shared the tasks into smaller ones for every member. At the end of the first week, I got big 5 from everyone. It was easy for them to carry out that task because it has been divided into smaller ones. Throughout the weekend, I analyzed their feedback, edited it, and collated everything together. At the beginning of the second week, the project was ready and it was submitted. Not to brag, but when the result was released, we had distinction, and my lecturer applauded me for 3 things which I didn't see.
1. My ability to make sure every member participates. Not just participate, but participate significantly. 2. My ability to enable accuracy in carrying out the project. He said, accuracy is the product of hard work, which he can see in me. 3. My high level of determination and punctuality, which he said are essential qualities of a good leader. I couldn't argue with him because that's just the fact about what he had. The sixth question likely to be asked is, do you prefer working alone or you prefer working with a team? This is a tricky question which comes often in many interview sections, and many people find it difficult to answer because many are self-appraising and have forgotten the essence of their fellow human being around them. It is pertinent to know that a firm or an organization is a large body containing 2 or more people, and for that reason, it is impossible for you to work alone in any firm or in any organization. A firm or an organization, an hiring manager or an interviewer will always want to employ someone who found pleasure in working with others. And for this reason, I have come with a perfect example answer to the question, do you prefer to work alone or to work with a team? I would say I prefer working with people of like-minded interest. When I work with people that have similar aims and goals with mine, it tends to yield distinction. However, this doesn't make me dependent, for I can work alone perfectly if I have to. I believe in the fact that a tree cannot form a forest, but a tree can be significant among other trees in the forest, just like the Iroko tree with its unique characteristics of being tall. I prefer working with teams, and also am always significant in my team. I have a good communicative skill, which makes it very easy for me to interact with people.
This is the end of today's episode on how to pass my interview. Please do ensure you click on the subscribe button, and I wish you success in your next interview section. All questions have been entertained, which you can ask your question through the mails on your screen or through the comment section. I promise to reply as soon as possible. Precious.